So we'll go ahead and get started. Hi, Kenneth. Thanks so much for joining us today. We're so grateful to be here and be a part of this conference. We're excited to talk today about caregivers and the prevention of prostate cancer. So a little bit about us. My name is Kate Gibbons. I am the Patient Education and Program Manager here with Zero the End of Prostate Cancer. And I am joined by Shelby Minear, who is my colleague and the Vice President of Patient Programs and Education at Zero as well. So we really wanted to spend the next few minutes talking about Zero the End of Prostate Cancer, our organization as a whole, some of our efforts that we're making, some of the programs that we have for caregivers, and also some information around prostate cancer prevention. So we'll go ahead and we'll get started by talking about Zero. So again, like I mentioned, the organization that we work for is Zero the End of Prostate Cancer. And Zero is the nation's leading nonprofit with a mission to end prostate cancer. So at Zero, we do a number of different things, a number of different efforts, including advocacy and research. So this is advancing research and advocacy at the local level, the state level, as well as the federal level. We advocate for access to care. We advocate for research and screening access as well. And then some of the other programs that you'll see here on our screen and in these slides is our Zero 360 program. Our Zero 360 program is our comprehensive patient support program. So this program helps both patients and caregivers. And in the past, this started in about 2016, and in the past few years, we've been able to help over 2,100 patients and their loved ones. And also, we've been able to help these people obtain nearly $2.7 million of debt relief. So we'll go a little bit more into that program further on in the presentation, but that is one of the big programs that we have available for both patient and caregiver support during the prostate cancer journey. We also have the Zero Mentor Program and our Caregiver Connector Program. So these are both of our peer-to-peer support programs. So we're going to talk a lot about Caregiver Connector today, but our peer-to-peer support basically means that patients and their loved ones are matched one-on-one with someone who has been through a similar or the same experience. And they're able to provide that support, talk through what they're going through, get their questions answered. Our mentor program is a one-on-one support program for patients. So this matches patients with survivors, trained volunteers that can talk on the phone or through email with somebody that is in need of support. And our Caregiver Connector program, which I mentioned we'll talk a little bit more about in a while, supports those who are currently caring for somebody with prostate cancer or somebody who's lost their loved one to prostate cancer. Next, I want to touch on one of our other big support programs, Zero Connect. Zero Connect is our online prostate cancer support network. So this is a closed Facebook support group, and we actually have over 2,700 members. And the members of our closed Facebook support group are prostate cancer patients, their prostate cancer survivors, their caregivers, loved ones, family, friends, people that are interested in prostate cancer prevention, people with questions about screening, rising PSA, things like that. It's just a really safe, neat space for 2,700 people to come together to really ask their questions and hear from other people that are going through similar things. We also have a number of awareness and education efforts. So we do share a lot of webinars. We do a lot of, like I said, on the ground local support as well. We have a national free testing sites database. So there is a map on our website on zerocancer.org that has a database of free or low-cost screening locations so people can find them all over the country if they'd like to be screened for prostate cancer. And then also we do community and online events. So some of our community events include local run walks. We have a number of them all over the country, as well as online events, which you'll see here, our logo for our upcoming Zero Summit that we're very excited about. This year, it will be an online event, and it will actually bring together experts. It'll bring together patients, survivors, caregivers, from actually all over the world this year, which we're very excited about. It will be taking place from February 28th to March 4th, and registration is on our website. At this event, we're excited to be able to provide support for caregivers too, and a space for caregivers to connect with other people that are going through the caregiver journey with prostate cancer patients. So that's just a little bit about Zero. Next, we want to jump a little bit more specifically into that caregiver connector program that we mentioned. So with our peer-to-peer support programs that we have, we've heard from patients, we've heard from caregivers that it's been extremely beneficial to be able to talk to someone who has walked in their shoes, been through similar situations, just somebody that can really answer the frank questions that they have to ask that they might not be able to ask their doctor, or they might not have anybody else in their space that they can ask. So it does say here, peer-to-peer support complements and enhances other healthcare services. It creates emotional, social, and practical assistance that's necessary for the prostate cancer caregiver journey. And so again, like I mentioned, the Caregiver Connector Program is how we support caregivers on their prostate cancer journey, or if they've lost their loved one to prostate cancer. So again, this provides very personalized matches for caregivers who are looking for one-on-one support. So the way that somebody reaches out to us for support is that applicants request support via an online form, and they're matched by our staff. So it's a really neat survey in the sense that we can make it super specific. The pairings are as specific as we can possibly get them. And that comes from the person who is reaching out for support. So we're able to ask questions like, what are you most interested in connecting with somebody on? And that can be, you know, I'd like to talk to somebody about how to communicate with my family when I'm trying to care for somebody with prostate cancer, or I'm concerned with talking to my loved one because sometimes I need a break and that's not as easy to say to him, or I'm having intimacy issues with my loved one, or how do I get around that? Or if it's somebody who's lost somebody to prostate cancer, they can talk about how they cope with their grief or steps to coping. So it's really neat in that we're able to make this as specific as we can based on what the person's looking for support. So who are our caregiver mentors? So after someone fills out this form for support, who are they matched with? Who are these people that we're providing for them to get support from? So our caregiver mentors, they're volunteers who are trained to share their experience. They share their insight. They offer support. Most importantly, they listen. So they're kind of a sounding board for the person that is in need of support. And our caregiver mentors, through our Caregiver Connector program, they've supported many, many different types of prostate cancer journeys. So we made sure when we were planning the program and creating the program, we know that not all caregiver relationships are the same. So we wanted to make sure that people were able to reach out to us no matter what type of caregiver relationship they've had. So our mentors actually have cared for their husbands, they've cared for their partners, they've cared for their fathers, their brothers, their sons, their friends, their neighbors, you name it. We've really tried to make sure that we have a caregiver mentor on standby so that they can support the caregiver regardless of the relationship that they have with their care recipient. So to become a caregiver mentor, our interested volunteers complete an application. They also read through a lengthy volunteer training manual, and they also have training with Zero staff as to what to expect, how to best share their stories, Zero programs, things like that. And so why does this work? Why have we seen such success? Why do people keep coming to us for support? Again, we mentioned that peer-to-peer support is just sharing similar experiences. So just being able to talk to somebody that's been through what you're going through has been invaluable to our Zero community. So again, it provides a safe space to really be able to ask the frank questions or the questions that you might be uncomfortable asking otherwise. They're able to find support from somebody that isn't a part of their life really, is newly becoming a part of their life. So they have no preconceived notions. They're really able to, you know, meet that caregiver where they are on the prostate cancer caregiver journey. So they're able to share their frustrations. They're able to share their fears. They're able to share their concerns, and it just provides a safe space all the way around. And then lastly, I just want to touch briefly on the critical role that caregivers play in the prevention of prostate cancer and really helping loved ones maintain their health and just be aware of their risk. So we hear a lot of times from the men that we work with that it was their caregiver or their loved one that really motivated them to go get screened or motivated them to ask their doctor about prostate cancer prevention. So we definitely like to highlight caregivers and shine a bright light on those efforts because having that conversation can sometimes be difficult. So really, caregivers play a huge role in the prostate cancer caregiver journey for many, many ways. Support from the beginning and all the way through. So here, I just want to highlight a few more programs that we have more specifically that can help with caregiver, the whole caregiver journey. So 0360, as I mentioned before, this program is a navigation program for caregivers and patients all the way through the prostate cancer journey. And the way that this program occurs is it's support from a case manager. So this case manager works with caregivers, works with patients all the way through. And what that case manager is able to do, we're really able to pull on their expertise, their knowledge, their backgrounds, their database of resources. And they're able to look into things like, you know, insurance navigation. So maybe you lost insurance because of you lost your job, or maybe you'll be switching insurance and you have questions about that. They're able to answer those questions. They're able to help with like Social Security disability navigation as far as applications, timelines, things like that. They're able to help find financial resources. So things like resources to help with medical bills, so copay assistance, but also with things like paying for electricity, or paying for transportation or rent or mortgages and things like that. So the neat thing about this program that I like to highlight is that that case manager is really there for that patient and caregiver every step of the way. And what I mean by this is that on average, the case manager makes 15 calls with the patient and the caregiver on the line. So this takes a whole level of stress off the caregiver because the caregiver doesn't have to remember what questions to ask if they're feeling overwhelmed. They don't have to be nervous about calling these resources because those case managers have that experience. So our 0360 program, I can't say enough good things about it. Those case managers really work to be able to solve issues and navigate the experience for patients and their loved ones. And then also, like I mentioned, Zero Connect, this is something, again, that I'll highlight, is our closed Facebook support group. Again, this is another safe space of 2,700 members of the prostate cancer community who have come together to be able to share and share their experience, ask their questions, and just be able to support one another. And I know Shelby will also mention this towards the end of our presentation, but also webinars, videos, guides. We have information that caregivers can turn to on our website, zerocancer.org, and learn more about the caregiving process, learn more about prostate cancer journey, learn more about connecting with other caregivers as well. So I do like to end with this quote from one of our caregiver mentors in our Caregiver Connector program. That's Deborah and her husband, Bob, right there. Deborah shared with us after becoming a caregiver mentor, she said, there's many times that the prostate cancer journey was up and down and it was hard. It was hard living with somebody, not knowing what to do and feeling emotional and not necessarily being able to get that emotional support that I needed at the time. So when the program came up, I thought, this is what I wanted when I was in the more active stages of my husband's protocol. So I wanted to be able to give to the program. I also get a fair amount from it too, still, because it reassures me that my feelings too are validated by talking to others. So that's something that we really like to highlight. The caregiver mentors also learn and feel supported by the pairings through the Caregiver Connector program. So with that, I will pass the mic to Shelby to talk to us about prostate cancer prevention and some facts and figures.
Excellent. Thanks so much, Kate. And it's a pleasure to be here on behalf of Zero and all of the Zero team. I just want to thank you for allowing us to participate. And actually, before we jump right into just some facts and stats and some basics on prostate cancer, some of you may not know what the prostate is or where it even lives. So I just wanted to make sure that we covered that, even if it's just very briefly. And so oftentimes people are asked what the prostate is or where it lives, and folks don't know. So the prostate is about a walnut sized shape and shaped gland. And it's just below the bladder and just in front of the rectum. And it's responsible for a couple of things, but one of those is it helps produce some of the fluid that is in semen. I just wanted to go over that briefly before we jumped right into some of these statistics. The American Cancer Society each year puts out a very large comprehensive report on various cancers. One of those is prostate cancer, and that comes out in January each year. So these numbers are brand new, and really, in full transparency, pretty staggering. In 2021, we're expecting almost 250,000 men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer. We're expecting more than 34,000 deaths this year. So these are up from last year, which is it's scary for us at zero. We want to make sure that we're improving awareness, increasing awareness, spreading the word about the importance of early detection and getting screened. And so that's what a lot of my talk will be on today for our remaining few minutes. But ultimately, we really just want men to know that they're not alone. They are joined by more than 3 million other men who are going through this experience. And, Kate went through all of the various resources that Zero has for you to make sure that you feel like you are supported and educated throughout this journey. Go ahead, Kate. So in Idaho, we just wanted to pull out some of these numbers to make this a little bit more specific for you. It is expected that you'll see an 8% increase in diagnoses since last year. So about 1,200 men are expected to be diagnosed in the state of Idaho, and about 200 deaths. So what we know is that with early detection and finding the prostate cancer early, you have almost 100% chance of being alive in 5 years. And unfortunately, that number goes down with the progression of the disease. So we just will really want to highlight the importance of early detection throughout the rest of our slides today. So really, we want to know what you can do. The first is to just know your risk. Race is really important. Black men are actually twice as likely to be diagnosed with prostate cancer and also to die from the disease. So very important based on your race, family history. What we've found out recently throughout research is actually that family history is really important. Also the BRCA gene, the BRCA gene, that's also actually named the breast cancer gene. This gene is also linked to prostate cancer. So family history is extremely important. And we've found really that people diagnosed with breast cancer tend to share their stories. They tend to talk to their families a little bit more than men do. And what we're really hoping throughout our efforts is that men begin to talk through their family history, share their experiences with their brothers and their sons and their uncles, their grandfather, so that family history is really shared and information is shared so that prostate cancer can be detected as early as possible. Some of the increase in statistics are thought to be due to the aging population because age is a very important risk factor. We talked a little bit about the gene changes, but also being exposed to certain chemicals. Veterans are actually also about twice as likely to be diagnosed with prostate cancer. Zero has some efforts around prostate cancer in veterans. We want to really protect our protectors. So we do have some initiatives focused on veterans and prostate cancer if you want to learn more at our website, which is zerocancer.org. The next is just to get tested. It's really about having a conversation, feeling empowered to talk about getting tested with your doctor. The doctor with you can determine when is the appropriate time to begin getting that PSA test and that baseline information so that you can make the most empowered decision and informed decision with your family. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle, very important, really. If it's good for your heart, it's good for your prostate. And then what we've already talked about, spreading the word, sharing your story, telling your friend, talking about it. And what we've found is that that peer-to-peer, what Kate mentioned with the support piece, the peer-to-peer sharing of information is really also quite impactful. You're a lot more likely to go get tested for prostate cancer if a friend tells you to do it or mentions it to you than you would be if I, for instance, are going to tell you to go get tested. So what we've already talked about, early detection is critical and crucial. Most men don't have too many symptoms until disease has progressed. So it just really speaks to the importance of knowing what your baseline PSA score is. And PSA stands for prostate specific antigen. So this is present in a blood test. And again, very few men have symptoms. And once it's a little bit later, some of those symptoms are difficulty urinating, excessive urination at night, difficulty with urination, and sometimes some issues with ejaculation. We talked a little bit about the risks, so I will, looking at the clock, skip that part. So prostate cancer testing, it's done in two ways. One is the PSA test, which is a blood test, and then the DRE, which is the digital rectal exam. And both of these together are really important. You can actually feel the prostate with a finger inserted into the rectum. And while this is scary and nerve-wracking for men, it's really important. It allows the physician to really feel the prostate and feel if there are anything, if there's anything to be concerned about. A lot about prevention is really just having a healthy diet, keeping those, having a healthy diet, but also exercising, having heart healthy, maintaining a healthy weight, heart healthy choices, exercising regularly, a healthy weight. So a little bit on the prevention pros and cons. Really, it's just about saving the life of someone you know and you care about. Having those conversations, encouraging men to talk with their physicians about getting tested, talking through their genetic history, their health risks, encouraging men to share their family history with their loved ones. And also it can create a regular schedule for your health screening. And this is something I mentioned, the BRCA gene for breast cancer. This is something that men and women alike can have these discussions about and make a plan to get tested for various cancers and various health screenings together as a family. I think the cons here are not true cons, but we'll talk about them anyway. I know sometimes, especially for women, we can be, and I can speak for myself here, we can be seen as a little bit naggy if we're constantly telling our spouses or partners or encouraging, maybe is a better word, to go get tested or to go to the doctor or to do various things that might make our partners a little bit more healthy. And there can be some financial strains by learning about your genetic history and going through genetic testing to eat specialized diets. Those types of things can cause some financial strain. So we have a ton of prevention and early detection resources on our website at zerocancer.org. We have various documents on questions to ask your doctor, how to make you feel informed and empowered to advocate for yourself and talk through what you need to know with your doctor. A lot of times it's hard to know what questions to ask. You don't know where to start, and you feel like you don't want to question your healthcare team because they're the professionals, they're the experts, but it's really important to go through the questions we've developed and put them together for you, and you can take those as a resource to your doctor's visit and really feel empowered to ask the questions and to get the answers. And if you don't understand the answers, don't be afraid to ask again and make sure that you're clear on the answers. We have a resource also that's really neat. It's a family tree map. And again, family history is a huge risk for prostate cancer. So this can help you understand and dive into your family tree and your family history, and make sure that you're talking to all of the right people. If you have a rising PSA level and you want to make sure that you're asking the right questions and talking to the right people in your family. And Kate mentioned a little bit some of the videos and webinars that we have. We have a ton of webinars and videos for patients and caregivers alike, covering a variety of topics. Kate also mentioned our summit. We have more than 1,000 people registered. We will be having more than 18 or 20 presentations for patients. We'll also be having some caregiver lounges as a part of our summit. So again, these are virtual, but we're really hoping to provide that education and support that both patients and caregivers alike need. So we have a lot of additional resources on our website. We have another great resource. I mentioned the family history and the BRCA gene, the BRCA gene. We also have some really interesting resources related to the BRCA gene and as it relates to prostate cancer and breast cancer. And with that, this is kind of a fun one, because we talked about sometimes the stereotypes of being a little bit of a nagging spouse, but our community member, Mark, said, "My wife saved my life because she finally convinced me to go to the doctor." And, you know, this happens throughout all cancers. We found that sometimes that caregiver in someone's life can really truly be the person who actually saved the life and helped that person find the cancer and detect that cancer early. And we know that early detection is crucial for saving a life, especially that of a prostate cancer patient. So with that, I want to thank you. Thanks to Kate for going through the first portion of the presentation. And thank you all for being a part of our day and letting us be a part of yours. And please keep in touch. If you need anything at all, please reach out, kate@zerocancer.org or shelby@zerocancer.org. And please don't forget to visit our website at zerocancer.org and caregiver-connector. We have a ton of great resources for you. So with that, I want to thank you and say goodbye.